Okay, I'm back. Had to do
he
something.
Understands how do you get separation.
Now here's Randolph. In the game
press
against New Orleans, very impressive.
They are really doing a nice job establishing a presence inside early.
That's going to open things up for them on the perimeter going forward, but both teams will make...
Deserve to be benched. I hate these smart shots.
Last outing for Utah, it was a loss to the Kings.
You know, it's a little bit surprising that the game got away from them, because for long stretches, they were the better team.
They really were. Outplayed them. If you looked only at the stat sheet, you'd have a hard time figuring out how they lost it. But it was a case of a few intangibles that didn't play out in their favor that made all the difference.
Hayward three and favors the four. Profit is out there with Hood, and it's Gobert in at the five, roaming the paint. That's the group right now for Utah. Here's Hood. After Jeff Green's bucket, tries to snap the cold streak. They get the rebound. Second shot opportunity. Nice shot by Gobert. Gobert's got the lead up to three now for the Jazz.
You know, that putback's about as easy as it's going to get. You have to put a body on someone down there.
Well, no box out. That's the result you get right there.
Now, here's Green. You saw him with 19 points his last outing. And the officials call goaltending, so they'll award the basket.
He almost got to that shot in time, but not quite. You can't touch the ball once it's on the way down.
Hood, the pass to the prop. Just under 3.5 minutes played here in the second quarter. And he'll shoot free throws here. Clearly fouled on that shot that time, the whistle blowing. And the foul goes against Memphis.
Way to play in attack mode and get inside.
And you know, if you're on defense and you're going to foul, make sure it's a good one. They did, preventing the and one. So far in the game for the Prophet, 9 points, and he's knocked down 5 shots at the charity stripe. Good numbers for him.
Yeah, good numbers, and that's been important for his team. They needed some points. He's provided some easy ones at the foul line, so he's making an impact here.
Okay.
Jazz have gone 5 of 8 from the floor here in the second quarter, over 60% shooting.
Well, Kostas Koufos was a player that Grizzlies have coveted for a couple of seasons. They ended up trading Darrell Arthur for him. And I like what they got. A starting caliber center, a good value on his contract, excellent defender. Really good trade for Memphis.
Conley dishes to Allen.
Well,
1:56 left to play in the first half. Here's Randolph. And the Grizzlies check on two more.
He's done a nice job, a great job, actually, of finding efficient shots here in the second. Shooting percentage always a function of the kinds of shots you get. Struggling a bit in the first.
No good from the Prophet.
They've been strong on the boards. There's no disputing that.
That's what the box score says. Still anybody's game, though.
Koufos kicks to Green. It's Allen on the wing. Pass to Randall. 11 feet away. That one rolling around and rims out.
Great look. Disappointing result.
You know, most times he knocks that one down.
Here's the Prophet. And the bucket counts. He's on his way to the free throw line. Try to make it a 3-point play.
He's tall for a shooting guard. He took full advantage of his height on that one.
Trey Burks checked in for Hood.
They struggled a bit at the line earlier, but they found a nice comfort zone there now here in the second. They've been red hot from the strike.
And let's now go to the sideline. We'll catch up here with Doris Burke. Doris?
Hey, guys. The Prophet in their last game against the Kings was superb. He had 20 points, and part of that scoring came from beyond the arc, adding a few threes to his already impressive season total. It was a great contribution from someone who's considered a bit more of a role player on his team.
Thank you, Doris. He was the player they leaned on that night, Steve, and he didn't disappoint them.
No, he didn't. In fact, he did everything they asked of him and more. And I think he really enjoys being that go-to guy for them.
Yeah, I think he relishes that because he knows he's capable of doing it. He's had some performances that have fortified his confidence in that role. So he's in a good place right now.
Wow. Little touch of class there, guys. The end of that play with the finger roll.
Utah's gone 0-3 from beyond the arc to start the second quarter. There's 18 seconds left to play here in the second quarter.
Oh, wasn't paying attention.
8 feet away. Excellent D there from Allen. Mm. And here comes Conley. Here's the three. and it would have counted had it fallen, but it's offline.
Tie second game corner. And we'll be back right after. I'm always pumped up in the second half.
All right, guys. I want to go over some things before we get back out there. A nice chunk.
The third quarter now beginning. And the last half of the game. The Prophet really making a difference here.
It didn't take long to see what kind of game he was going to have today. He came out very aggressively and had a terrific first half.
You know, you look at his shot chart, it's all draped up. I mean, he's right at the rim. He's driving the lane again and again.
So on the four for Memphis. Conley and Allen are the guard set. Randolph and Kufis are inside. And it's Green in at the small forward.
Well, you know, for teams in the NBA nowadays, it's all about getting bang for your buck. I mean, Mike Conley out of Ohio State, one of the great value contracts in the league, and with all the analytics and general managers looking for value, Memphis happy to have an all-star caliber still player like him still locked up for 2016.
All three throws good from the Prophet. And you have to give Mike Conley, Steve, an awful lot of credit for the emergence of the Grizzlies. I think is a factor in the Western Conference.
Kevin, I think he's one of the best point guards of the league. Probably doesn't get enough credit, but his progression as a player at both ends, year after year, he just seems to get better, and he provides that poise and leadership that his club needs.
Now, here's Burke, still getting warmed up offensively. No buckets yet in the game for him. Favors passes to the Prophet. Favors with the ball. Kufis is there. Burke kicks to Hayward. And the pass to the Prophet. Now the feed to Hayward. Stolen by Randolph.
Don't know my friend. He could.
Green against Hayward. Green dishes to Conley. Looks for Randolph. Gets it to him. Tipped away.
Well, his shot's been off today, no question. He's not the guy they're going to want to look to if they want to keep this lead where it is.
Nice ball movement by Utah. Here's the Prophet. It's good, the assist that time from Burke. 18 points for the Prophet.
Boy, the D has to show a little more fight on the interior than they did on that.
Just as I thought, best player on the team. They are nothing without me.
They got a battle inside.
Well, this game has been tough, Clark. I mean, they're getting after it, and I think they're starting to run a little bit low on energy, possibly.
Now, here's Green. He has seven, and they will get the basket here, folks, as they rule goaltending.
Good job at the line.
Hey, Trevor Booker. Never look for Utah. Favors comes in for Jeremy Evans. And Hood subbed in for Gordon Hayward. And Memphis also making a switch. Randolph is checked in. Lee kicks to Aminu.
I'm seeing him pound.
There's 48 seconds left in the third quarter of the game. Stokes, the pass to Aminu. Five to shoot. Carter with a three. Booker pulls it in.
Well, he's gone without a field goal. That certainly is below par for him. His team has still found a way to get it done.
The Prophet's checked in for the Jazz. Green, he's checked in for the Grizzlies. Allen comes in for Al-Farouq Aminu. The Prophet passes to Booker. Here's the Prophet, defended by Allen. Another miss by Utah. And the Grizzlies leading by four. Lee dishes to Green. It's rebounded by Derek Favors. Favors has got his fourth rebound in this one. Here's the Prophet, defended by Carter. The Prophet passes to Hood. And that's not going to go.
Come on, level two. Well,
it's been an exciting. And State Farm assist to the game coming on some very clever point guard play.
Well, he mans that position for a reason, Kevin, because he passes the ball so well, sets up his teammates beautifully, really gets this offense into a nice rhythm.
In the right place for shooters, as you well know, you.
Yeah, no question.
Jazz trail by four. Hayward three and favors the four. Alec Burks is out there with the Prophet. And it's Gobert in at the five.
Oh.
That's the group right now for Utah. And it's Memphis on the break. Allen outside. There's the pick. Over in the corner, Green. A three ball. Here's Kufis. Rebound, Utah. Gobert's got his fifth rebound in this one. Burks the pass to the Prophet. To the wing on the left. And that one's good. LeProvitz got the first basket as we get going in the fourth for the Jams.
He had his head on the swivel and was able to pick out the pass and get the assist.
Lee kicks to Allen. Down low. Here's Kufis. Shot is off. So Utah will take it the other way. They get to take on the Blazers of Portland after this one. That'll be just one game played away from home for them. To tie it up. No good from the Prophet. Memphis leading, and here we go with Allen running it up the court. Here's Green. Utah with the rebound. Gobert has got six rebounds here tonight. Here's the Prophet, covered by Lee. The Prophet passes to Favors. Burks kicks to Hayward. Bangs home the trifecta. Game winding down, and they just keep changing leads.
Absolutely. I mean, six lead changes here so far.
Steve, exciting stuff.
Yeah, I know this is a fun game to watch. Which team can kind of extend the lead and make a couple of big plays here to try to seize it?
Let's go. You're in.
Hey, well done.
Memphis has gone 1-2 from three-point range here in the fourth. Conley dishes to Allen. He kicks to Green. Randolph against Favors. Back to Green. Down to five on the shot clock. And he gets it to go. And the Grizzlies lead by three.
He's been one of their more reliable options today, guys. I mean, his shooting.
Jazz have gone 3-5 here in the fourth quarter. Pretty good numbers coming out of the break. Here's the Prophet, defended by Allen. Burke, the pass to the Prophet. Here's Favors. Allen with the rebound.
I thought he rushed it a little bit, guys, because he had a clean look, just lost his focus.
Conley kicks to Randolph.
Hard to stop.
No good. And it's Utah the other way. Hayward with the ball. Took him no time at all on that one.
The entire defense was frozen footed. Nobody picked up the shooter, Kevin.
Memphis has gone 2-3 in the fourth quarter from long range. Good shooting so far. They set the pick. Allen outside. There's the dish to Randolph. Passes it to Kufis. Inside. That's good from Allen on the assist by Kufis. And it's 6 points for Allen.
Nothing too fancy, just simple execution. That's getting the job done when they need to make every possession count.
I agree, Clark. They need stops, and they can't afford any wasted possessions. Those inside shots are really high-percentage looks.
Puts up the baby hook. Good on that shot, and with that, the Memphis lead is cut down to just one on the bucket from the Prophet.
I don't know if he's tired or what, but he's finding it very difficult to score here in the fourth.
And so he earns a trip to the line. Officials saw the contact, and he'll shoot two.
What a great game for Randolph in this. He has 11 points. He's added a steal to his stat line also.
Now that's obviously not a big number, but he's been doing some valuable defensive work for him.
And he is unable to get the second one.
Yeah, they seem to be looking for chances inside a little bit more this half.
And I love that mentality. You talked about it earlier, being the aggressor. It's the right way to play with the lead. Keep attacking.
This quarter has not been his best. The defense may be starting to affect him a little bit.
Conley left side. And so he draws the foul on the shot. A trip to the line to shoot two. Breaking down some numbers here. The hustle stats for the Grizzlies.
Boy, they're hounding, harassing effort at the defensive end. Very impressive. And they force quite a few turnovers as a result.
The other thing they're doing, guys, is forcing turnovers and then creating points off of it.
Work gets to Hayward. Here's the Prophet, defended by Allen. There's 1:17 left in the fourth quarter. Clock at six. Fires the three. And the shot is good. The Grizzly lead will cut down to just one on the basket for Burke.
And in a virtual free look at a three-point shot, the defense completely lost him there.
We got a minute to go.
Let's make some noise.
Outside, Green. Ball's not loose. Now, here's Burke, defended by Allen. Kicks it to Burke. Here's the Prophet. Nails it!
A crucial basket. They needed it, and he gave it to
them. There's 49 seconds left in the fourth quarter. Conley dishes to Green. He feeds it to Randolph. Buries it!
So it's really hard to stop Randolph right now.
40 seconds left in the fourth quarter. Burke, the pass to the Prophet. Dishes to Burke. Inside to Faber. And Zach Randolph gets the whistle that time. Here's the Prophet, defended by Allen.
They do have a foul to give here. Yeah, you might see them use that at some point. I would.
Stand up and make some noise!
19 seconds left in the fourth quarter of this one. Outside Conley. Allen kicks to Randolph. Goes up the baseline.
It's in!
Good ball movement. You put that pass in the ideal spot, right where it needed to be.
Here's Burke. Pass to the Prophet. It's good.
Let's go.
Sends up a prayer. Oh, that shot had a chance, but no good. And so it's Utah who scraped by with a win. Well, they don't get much more exciting than that, Clark.
They sure don't. And when it was gut check time, this team kept their composure, kept their emotions in check, and got it done.
And that about wraps it up for Clark Kellogg, Steve Kerr, and Doris Burke. This is Kevin Harlan thanking you for watching the NBA presented by 2K Sports. And now, Jordan presents our player of the game, The Prophet.
The Prophet, player of the game. Let's go. Yeah. You already heard it. He said the Prophet's player of the game. And he's right. Let's see what they got to say about that game. They're probably going to thank me and be like, oh, you did good out there. Watch this. After the game, in the locker room. No, I guess not. Whatever. Look at all those fans. They love me.
First up to back, no batteries included, and no strings attached, no holds barred.
Subscribe to Wars Games on YouTube, hit that like button, follow me on Twitter, hope to have the latest, subscribe to Wars, whatever, I'm just repeating everything. Okay, see you guys later.